Hello students, I am Dr. Kalyani Kakar, working as an assistant professor in Department of Pharmacology, Progressive Education Society, Modern College of Pharmacy, Negri Pune. In this session, discussion is on adulteration of crude drugs. Drug adulteration. The adulteration and substitution of herbal drug is the burning problem in herbal industry, and it has caused a major effect in commercial use of natural product. Adulteration in market sample is one of the greatest drawback in promotion of herbal products. Adulteration, it is a practice of substituting the original crude drug partially or fully with other substances, which is either free from or inferior in therapeutic and chemical properties, or addition of low grade or spoiled drug or entirely different drug similar to that of original drug, substituted with an intention of enhancement of profit. Or adulteration may be defined as a mixing or substituting the original drug material with other spurious, inferior, defective, spoiled, useless, other part of same or different plant or harmful substances or drug which do not conform with the official standard. Adulteration may take place by two ways. The first is direct or intentional adulteration. Second, indirect or unintentional adulteration. Direct or intentional adulteration is done intentionally, which usually includes practice in which an herbal drug is substituted partially or fully with other inferior product. Due to morphological resemblance to the authentic herb, many different inferior commercial varieties are used as an adulterant. These may or may not have any chemical or therapeutic potential. Substitution by exhausted drug. This practice is most common in case of volatile oil containing material, where the dried exhausted material resembles the original drug but is free of essential oil. Foreign matter such as other part of the same plant with no active ingredient, sand and stones and synthetic inferior principle are used as a substitute. With artificially manufactured material, these are the substances artificially manufactured being resembled with original drug are used as a substitute. This practice is generally followed for much costlier drug. For example, nutmeg is adulterated with basswood prepared to the required shape and size. The colored paraffin wax is used in place of this wax. Second, with inferior quality materials. Inferior quality materials may or may not have same chemical or therapeutic value as that of original natural drug due to their morphological resemblance to authentic drug. They are marketed as a adulterant. Example, belladonna leaves are substituted with ailanthus leaves, papaya seeds to adulterate piper nigrum. Mother clove and clove stars are mixed with clove. This wax is substituted by Japan wax. Next, with exhausted material, many drugs extracted on large scale for isolation of active principle, volatile oil, etc. The exhausted material may be used entirely or in part as a substituent for the genuine drug. For example, umbelliferous fruit and clove are adulterated with exhausted original drug. Exhausted jala and Indian hemp are used as an adulterant. These are the examples of some adulteration done by exhausted material. With foreign matter, sometimes synthetic chemicals are used to enhance the natural characters. For example, addition of benzene benzoate to balsam of Peru, citral to citrus oil like oil of lemon and orange oil, etc. The practice of international adulteration is mainly encouraged by traders who are reluctant to pay premium prices for herb of superior quality. and hence are inclined to purchase only the cheaper products. This encourages producers and traders to sell herb of inferior quality. The next class is with harmful or fictitious substances. Sometimes the waste from market are collected and admixed with the authentic drugs, particularly for liquids or unorganized drugs. For example, pieces of amber colored glass in colophony, limestone in asafoetida, lead components in opium, white oil in coconut oil, coca butter with stearin or paraffin. Adulteration of powders. Besides entire drug powder form, frequently found to be adulterated, example, powder licorice or gentian admixed with powder of polio stones under the name of Cinchona. Some other components are available as a mixtures. Second class, indirect or unintentional adulteration. Unintentional or undeliberately adulteration which sometimes occur without bad intention of a manufacturer or supplier. Sometimes in the absence of proper means of evaluation, an authentic drug partially or fully devoid of the active ingredient may enter the market. Factors such as geographical sources, growing condition, processing and storage are all factors that influence the quality of a drug. In this, the first example is adulteration may be some of the herbal adulteration is due to the careless of the herbal collectors and the suppliers. The correct part of a genuine plant should be collected. Other less valuable part of the genuine plant should not be collected. Moreover, collection should be carried out at a proper season and time when the active constraints reach maximum. Example, Dhatura leaves should be collected during the flowering stage and wild cherry bark in autumn, etc. Collection from the other plant by ignorance due to similarity in the appearance, color, lack of knowledge may lead to adulteration. Next example, in place of Aconitum, the other species may be collected, or in place of a Ranas, confusion existing in the common vernacular name of different plant in various states of India may lead to this type of adulteration. Often in different states, the same plant is known by the different vernacular names. While quite different drugs are known by same name, this creates confusion, which is the best illustrated by the Punarnava and Brahmi. Imperfect preparation. Non-removal of associated structure, for example, stems are collected with leaves, flowers and fruits. Non-removal of undesirable parts or structure, example, cork should be removed from ginger rhizomes. Proper drying conditions should be adhered. Improper drying may lead to the unintentional adulteration, for example, if digitalis leaves are dried above 65 degrees Celsius, decomposition of glycosides by enzymatic hydrolysis, use of excessive heat in separating the core liver oil from liver, where the proportion of vitamin, odor and color, etc. are adversely affected. Incorrect storage, deterioration especially during the storage leading to the loss of active ingredient, production of metabolites with no activity and in extreme cases the production of toxic metabolites. Physical factors such as air, humidity, light and temperature can bring about deterioration directly or indirectly. These factors alone or in combination can lead to the development of organisms such as mold, mites and bacteria. Oxidation of the constituents of the drug can be brought about by oxygen in the air, causing some products such as essential oil to rancidify or to become a rancid. Gross substitution with plant material. Due to morphological resemblance, that is similarity in appearance, color, etc., the genuine fruit drugs are substituted with others are very often sold in market. Example, Podophyllum peltatum is used as a substitute for Podophyllum hexandrum. Belladonna leaves are substituted with Ailanthus leaves. Saffron is admixed with the dried flower of Carthamus. Mother clove and clove stars are mixed with clove. Substitution with the exhausted drugs. In this type, the same drug is admixed with the devoid of any medicinally active constituent as they are already extracted out. This practice is more common in case of volatile containing drugs like fennel, clove, coriander, caraway, etc. Sometimes, character of analytical evaluation of herbal drug, exhausted drug like color and taste are manipulated by adding other additives and then it is substituted by exhausted material. So these are the various ways of adulteration in a crude drug. Thank you, everyone.